consent. What a good boy, what a smart boy, what a strong boy.
Every time somebody came and said, oh, what a cute dog, I said, yeah, she's a very cute dog, but you have to know, she does have this heart condition, she's fine now. She really was having a hard time here because she's not as active as the other dogs and they were getting up on her. But somebody who adopted her has a heart defect. And he said, I have to take this dog. It's just an amazing story. There are so many homeless dogs, it's so hard to find a home for a healthy dog. His girlfriend said, I think he really loves her because he now feels the way his parents felt when they were going to the doctors and they didn't know what was going to be. So now, you know, he's going for the cardiograms. She had very good luck because they love her.
Community social worker for the city of Jerusalem. I spend half my day helping animals and half my day helping people. And I don't think that we can have happy people without healthy animals and healthy animals without happy people. There's dreams and there's fantasies. One of our dreams is to be able to maintain a good level of maintenance for the dogs and the cats. Fantasy is that we no longer needed.
In conjunction with another nonprofit organization, we opened a low-cost spay neuter clinic, which is the first of its kind in Jerusalem. We do low-cost sterilization of dogs and cats for anybody. Plus, we do street cats for the many, many, many cat feeders in Jerusalem.
The mother is there. Maybe I should put them together. 500,000 dogs are born every year. We only have 250,000 homes every year for dogs that live 10 to 15 years. There are no records anywhere of the amount of cats in this country, and their death rate would probably be much higher.
Now we have a vet here, like Janet. The animals are looked at every time she comes here. She goes into all of the yards. We do spraying against ticks and other pests twice a year, which keeps the dogs much healthier. I mean, if you walk around, dogs pretty much look healthy and happy, as happy as they can be not having a family of their own. Seeing dogs in animal shelters, in cages by themselves. We made a conscious decision not to keep our dogs like that. This way they have a social life. At least they live their time with a group of dogs and not alone in a cage. So that's why maybe it looks a little dirty, but at least they have a family life. We think of it as a skeleton staff, even though they're great and they keep the place looking good and they love the animals and they're here when we need them. It would be great to pay even more people because you can always clean more. You can always give the animals more attention. Animals that you want to adopt out as pets have to have attention. We have dreams of hiring somebody who would be a staff trainer / rehabilitator for those dogs and cats that need extra help. We would like to cement all of the yards, which makes it much easier to clean and it makes it much easier to keep the ticks away. We always need blankets and sheets, toys, leashes, collars, tick collars.
There are lots of loving, loving animals like this at the JSPCA for adoption. But his chances of being adopted out are not very high because there are just too many of them.
On Tuesdays, we'll have a group of kids from a program for teenagers who need a little...
Troubled teenagers.
Right? They're great. They do everything we ask them to, and they do it enthusiastically. It's, you know, for us, it's part of educating the next generation.
Cut this picture.
This is an adoption day. I bring dogs to find families from them every 2 weeks on Friday. And this market allows us to do it in front of many people. And I hope they adopt. These children that you see, they are from school. It's an obligation that they do for us. It's called מחויבות אישית.
בעצם העבודה שלנו היא לדאוג שהכלבים האלה לא יברחו, שישתו כשהם צריכים. היצורים הבעלי ארבע הרגליים לא באמת יכולים לטפל בעצמם לבד, אז צריך מישהו שיעשה את זה. ואני לא מאמינה שאם אני לא אעשה את זה אז מישהו אחר כן, כי פשוט כל זוג ידיים הכרחים.
Everywhere. I ask him to be nice, to prevent cruelty against animals. So we ask, we plea to come to a dog.
This is the clinic that belongs to JSPCA, Tzar Bale Chaim. The clinic was opened about 7 years ago.
This is Navitus.
In the industrial area of Talpiot. We have lovely neighbors, it's accessible. The clinic operates 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. It's only closed one day a year, and that's for Yom Kippur.
The fact that we can help dogs and cats that does not have someone else to treat them or take care of them is just is the whole purpose of becoming a vet for me. We do see here some very, very rough things, but it makes me happy to know that we can take care of animals that have no one else in the world to take care of them.
It's not unusual for somebody to call at 1 o'clock in the morning and say, I just drove by and saw a dog sitting alone on the sidewalk. Sometimes a chip will say the owner's in Akko or the owner's in Haifa or the owner's somewhere else. So at night we bring the animals here and we keep them here until morning until we can find the owners.
This dog was found chained in the forest to a tree. He's been there for maybe a week or two, and the chain just cut his neck all over. So you can see he has a really bad wound there. He's been treated here for more than a week, maybe 10 days, so the wound is doing better, but he's deteriorating. He has kidney and liver problems because he did not eat or drink during this entire period. The cat's staying there. Someone raised him in his yard and then he got sick. And they decided they don't want to keep on feeding him and treating him, so they brought him here. All the other kittens just have eye problems and respiratory problems, and that's usually very easy to treat with antibiotics and some fluids, and they're doing very well. Someone just got rid of it and threw it in the trash, and the pigeon just has a broken wing and probably will never fly again. We had a Pekingese that came here, around 2 or 3 year old, with his eye just popping out of the eye socket. And he had a microchip, and we called the owner, and she said that she does not want to have a dog with one eye. And he was the cutest little puppy. Eventually, he ended up in one of our volunteers' house, and she just loves him. So that's just a happy story.
Somebody is really trying to help us and wants to donate something. We need a new x-ray machine. It breaks down every 7 months. We just keep patching it and putting it back together. An x-ray is a very important part of treatment, especially when an animal's been in an accident or been abused, kicked, hit. How many animals do we adopt out a year?
A year, between 300 and 400.
How many do we get in?
At least 1,000. We never said no. People are calling us all the time. People say, you know, I can't keep my dog anymore, I'm taking care of it anymore.
To answer.
An animal that grew up in a home, in a shelter, just because you don't feel like taking care of it anymore.
If somebody finds a mutilated cat on the street that needs to have an amputation or needs to have major surgery, we very often will take care of it. We have the problem of who's going to finance it. Financing street animals comes at the expense of feeding and taking care of the animals here. There's always a very delicate balance between what we can afford to do and what we have to do, and that's why we need help. There are organizations that cry wolf, and say, you know, we're gonna shut down, and they say that 3 or 4 times a year. We rarely say anything close to that. We say, we're making it, and our animals are healthy, and our animals are happy, but we'd like to do so much more, and we can do more.
Kindness to an animal is chesed shel emet. It's the greatest kindness. I wish I could take every stray animal home, but I can't.
And we want to somehow do more education, more advertising about the need to adopt animals and never ever
shelter
buy,
animals.
Never ever breed. because of the terrible situation. Not the terrible conditions they live in, just the fact that so many animals don't have a home.
They don't see it. They don't understand it. And that's why people are letting their dogs have litters in the house. And a lot of them end up here in the shelter. Shelters have become a warehouse to hoard animals because people don't want them. That's not what should happen. A shelter should be a sanctuary for animals that need help. Okay, it's not a solution to overpopulation. Spaying and neutering is the only humane solution.
It's one planet, we're going to have to work together, and we really don't have a whole lot of a choice about that.
On the back of a motorbike, with your arms outstretched, trying to take flight, leaving everything behind.